everyone, welcome to the maths class. Earlier we have started with the chapter reflection. Now objectives related to this chapter are introduction of coordinate axis and reflection on x-axis, y-axis and origin. Second objective is single transformation and double reflection. Then invariant points and reflection of a point on a line by using graph paper, and by using graph paper reflect points on x-axis, y-axis and origin. So today we are going to discuss single transformation and double reflection. So first of all, what is single transformation? So here look at the example. So first of all, after reflection in x-axis, here sign of ordinate will change. So 2 will change into minus 2. So points are a dash 5 comma minus 2. Now a dash is reflected to y-axis. So after reflection in the y-axis, it means changes will come in the abscissa sign. So a double dash is minus 5 comma minus 2. We have to find single transformation here, a onto a double dash. It means from a to a double dash. Here firstly reflection in x-axis is there, then y-axis. Now only origin is left. So here reflection in the origin. Now other way is for single transformation. Point A is 5 comma 2 and point A double dash is minus 5 comma minus 2. Here plus signs are there, and in A double dash both signs are minus. It means here change in both abscissa and ordinate signs. So reflection is in the origin only. So here single transformation is origin here. Now look at the first example. The point A minus 3 comma 2 is reflected in the x-axis to the point A dash. Point A dash is then reflected in the origin to point A double dash. So first part is write down the coordinates of A double dash and write down a single transformation that maps A onto A double dash. So point is A minus 3 comma 2 is reflected in x-axis. Then point name is A dash. It means x-axis means changes will come in the ordinate sign. So point is minus 3 comma minus 2. Now point A dash is then reflected in the origin and name is A double dash. So after reflection in the origin, here sign of both abscissa and ordinate will change. So A double dash coordinates are 3 comma 2. Now second part is write down a single transformation that maps A onto A double dash. Now single transformation from A onto A double dash is x-axis already done, origin also done. So left out is reflection in y-axis. So single transformation is reflection in y-axis. So first part answer is A double dash 3 comma 2 and second part answer is reflection in the y-axis. Now second example is the triangle ABC where A 2, 6, B minus 3, 5, C 4, 7 is reflected in the y-axis to triangle A dash, B dash, C dash. So triangle A dash, B dash, C dash is then reflected in the origin to triangle A double dash, B double dash and C double dash. So first of all we have to find Write down the coordinates of A double dash, B double dash and C double dash and write down a single transformation that maps triangle ABC onto triangle A double dash, B double dash and C double dash. So first of all, coordinates of A, B and C we have to write. A 2, 6, B minus 3, 5 and C 4, 7. So first of all, we have to do reflection in y axis. Reflection in y axis means changes will come in the abscissa sign. So 2 will change into minus 2, minus 3, plus 3 and 4, minus 4. So coordinates are A dash minus 2, 6, B dash 3, 5 and C dash minus 4, 7. Now triangle A dash, B dash, C dash is then reflected in the origin. Now origin means sign of both abscissa and ordinate will change. So A double dash is 2, -6, B double dash is -3, -5 and C double dash is 4, -7. So first part, we have to write coordinates of A double dash, B double dash and C double dash. So A double dash is 2, -6, B double dash is -3, -5 and C double dash is 4, -7. Now second part is write down single transformation that maps from triangle ABC to A double dash, B double dash and C double dash triangle. So here y axis action is done, origin also done, so left out is only reflection in x axis. So here single transformation is reflection in x axis. Third example is find the image of point P 4, -6 under first part reflection in x axis and reflection in y axis. So according to the first part, reflection in x axis and reflection in y axis of the point 4, -6 we have to do. So first part is reflection in x axis and y axis point 4, -6. So first of all we have to do reflection in y axis first. Reflection in y axis means changes in abscissa will come. So here -4, -6. Now we have to do reflection in x axis here. So x axis means changes will come in the ordinate sign. So -6 will change into +6. So required coordinates are -4 and 6. Now we have to write single transformation also. So here x axis and y axis reflection is done. So single transformation is left out, that is reflection in the origin. Now second example is reflection in y axis and x axis here. So first of all we have to do reflection in x axis here. Here reflection in x axis means we have to change the sign of ordinate here. So -6 will change into +6 here. So now we have to do reflection in y axis. It means abscissa sign will change. So +4 will change into -4. So required coordinates are -4, 6. Now single transformation. Reflection in y axis and x axis already done. So left out is origin. Reflection in the origin. Third part is reflection in x axis and origin. So first of all we have to do reflection in origin, that point 4, -6. So origin means both sign will change. So +4 changes into -4 and -6 changes into +6. Now we have to do reflection in x axis. So after reflection coordinates are -4, -6. This is the required coordinate. Now single transformation according to this, reflection in x axis and origin already done. So here left out is reflection in y axis. This is the single transformation. Now next example is reflection in origin and y-axis. So first of all we have to do reflection in y-axis. So it means we have to change sign of abscissa. So plus 4 will change into minus 4. Now we have to do reflection in origin. It means sign of both abscissa and ordinate will change. So required coordinates are 4 and 6. Now single transformation according to this. Here origin and y-axis reflection is already done. So left out is reflection in x-axis here. Now students, you are able to do sums related to this topic that will come in your SNAP homework. Thank you and have a nice day.